Hello, people. I feel like I've been having really good meals lately, but I haven't been filming them, so I figured I'd start now. Welcome to this week's edition of What We Ate for Dinner. Okay, so I just cut up some Brussels sprouts and used the remnants of the Parmesan seasoned Parmesan? I don't know, for the Parmesan crusted tilapia we have there. It's just Parmesan, a little bit of paprika, salt, pepper, and I think that's it. Yep, that's pretty much it. And then Brussels sprouts. You pop it in the oven at 400 degrees, just 400, not and, for like 15 minutes, and then dinner is served. All right, another slam dunk. Actually, we haven't eaten it yet, so I don't know if it's a slam dunk, but the recipe looks like a slam dunk. So another one pan dinner. Do you guys like these? I feel like they're so easy. You just throw a bunch of stuff on a pan, toss it in the oven, and then, you know, you wait 30 minutes and it's dinner time. Perfect for after school, especially if you have like after school activities and stuff and don't have a lot of time in the evening and would rather spend it with your children. Do you feel me? Anyway, okay, so this is chicken, and basically it's almost the same as the fish, but I mixed together. First you put on like olive oil and then just some lemon juice on the chicken, and then dredge it in. This is breadcrumbs and what is this? This kind of cheese, Parmesan cheese and Romano cheese. And what kind? Asiago. Ooh, we're so fancy up in here. Probably not that much of that, but maybe like half a cup each. And then dredge it all over the chicken, and I sprinkled some on the carrots, and I'm going to let this cook for like 30 minutes. I have it on a lower temperature, 350, and then the last, I don't know, 10 minutes or so, I'll throw those on, and I'll dredge those in here with some olive oil, and then just toss those on, and we'll see what it looks like when it's done. Hopefully it looks, slash, also tastes absolutely delicious. Let's see. Also made some banana bread. Yum! All right, guys, I forgot to get a shot of it on the pan for you. It just looks so good, you know, on the pan, all nice and neat. Anyway, this is our plate. mine, Alex's, I don't know, he'll probably eat more chicken than me, and then the girls. So, came out looking delicious. I hope it tastes good. I'll let you know. All right, dinner number three, sheet pan. I have green beans over here that I'm going to add to this corner, and I will show it to you when it's done cooking. I hope I don't forget, but it might happen. So tonight is just meatloaf, and basically this is our starch, just potatoes, and then any vegetables that you want. I bought the like 700 pound bag of carrots from Costco, so I'm just trying to eat all of those up before they dry out and go bad. So meatloaf kind of looks gross when it's not cooked, right? Anyway, I'm going to throw that in the oven, and it just preheated for me, so hallelujah. Let me throw it in. And in case you're like me and don't meal prep slash prepare for things like this, I didn't have a meatloaf seasoning packet. Excuse my handwriting, like that's embarrassing. But I just went online and I jotted this down really quickly. It's basically dried mustard, paprika, salt, dried thyme, basil, pepper, garlic powder, and onion powder, if you can't read my chicken scratch. And I had all of those spices, so I just threw them in a bowl and wada boom, bada bang, threw it all together. And then you add just a little bit of milk, breadcrumbs, or cornflake, like crushed cornflakes if you want, or crackers. I know some people use crackers. And then a little bit of milk. Did I say that? Milk, breadcrumbs, and ketchup.
All right, there it is, all finished. Oh boy, does that look good or what? I don't know why meatloaf gets a bad rep. Do you guys know? I never had it growing up, and the first time I tasted it, my aunt made it, and I was like, this is the most delicious thing I've ever had in my life. So I made all that. I also made some gravy just from a packet seasoning, and then some frozen rolls. Boom, dinner is done. All right, guys, another sheet pan meal for you. This is the marinade. I am going to make salmon. So I have my salmon just de-thawing a little bit in there, and then I'm going to take them out of the packages and make this marinade. You need sweet chili sauce, some soy sauce, but I have coco enos. I have no idea. It's like I think that's a soy-free version. Yeah, it's soy-free, gluten-free, delish. Some garlic, and then you need orange marmalade. I don't have that, so I'm just going to use orange juice. Here is the recipe that I always use. It's a super winner, so I'm going to throw that together and then show you what it looks like.
Actually, I'm going to marinate it for an hour and then throw it together. So I'll see you soon. All right, so there it is marinating. You want to put it skin side up so the, you know, the meat of the fish gets all that delicious juicy marinade. I do want to add that I put in a little bit more of this sweet chili sauce, probably almost double, because it's a really good sauce to put on like rice and stuff if you cook rice with it. So Wentworth is cooking with me per the usual. So I'm going to cover this, let it sit for an hour, and then I'll show you the rest. Okay, so technically this isn't a one pan dinner, but you do throw all the stuff in the oven at the same time. So right before you cook it, just turn the salmon around so the top can get nice and like golden brown. I'm preheating my oven right now to 400 or 425 degrees. You could put this in the broiler if you're not cooking anything else, just for like, I don't know, 10, 15 minutes, I wanna say. Keep an eye on it, you know, it's a broiler. But at 425, I leave it in for like 20 minutes, and that allows time for all of this stuff to cook too. Those are Hush Puppies, where's the bag? I found these, I didn't even know these existed. I've always made them from scratch before, and we haven't had them in, I wanna say like 2 years or so, but so delicious. How can you have fish without Hush Puppies? Oh my gosh, my mouth is watering already. And I feel like I should make way more Brussels sprouts. And I'm also making rice, which isn't on a pan, plate, whatever that's called. But I don't know, my kids, I feel like they might not like the Hush Puppies. So I'm gonna make them happy with the rice. Anyway, I'm gonna throw that in the oven. I also wanted to add before I forgot, I was looking at the label and actually like, looking at it rather than just, you know, sometimes you look at words and you're like, oh, I don't know how to say that, so I'm just gonna pretend like I don't know how to say it and make up my own word. Anyway, aminos, like amino acids, I'm assuming. So it's called cocoa aminos. Is that what I said before? I don't know. I can't remember. I feel like I just said something weird, so I wanted to clarify. Look at that. Doesn't that look so delicious? And all this stuff you can pour over the rice. Oh my gosh, it's so good. I realized I didn't make enough rice. I'm not eating any because we have Hush Puppies. That will be my carb, but, oh, and side note, oh my gosh, these little crispy bits off the Brussels sprouts, they taste like Brussels chips or something. Well, that's not one. Where is one? Here it is. My gosh, it's so hot, but so crispy. Oh my gosh. If you ever had kale chips, that's what they taste like, but Brussels sprouts, so good. All right, I'm gonna dish it up. And we're gonna eat. And I don't know if you're interested in this, but if you're worried about the skin, like it just peels right off. You don't even have to worry about it. If I had two hands, it would like peel right off in one piece. Do you see it? Oh, and it's blurry. Sorry, guys. There we go. It just peels off like if the fish is cooked. I used to have them fillet it at the fish counter, but it's totally not necessary. Doesn't that look good? I wish I would have got that one on camera, the skin peeled off, all in one piece. Master chef here. Somebody call Food Network. All right, I can't wait to dive into these. All right, people, here it is. This is the last one dish pan I'm gonna show you. And technically, again, I should just call this like oven meals. I mean, you could throw the chicken on there and make it a one pot, one dish meal, but this is called officially, I think it's called Chicken Mirabella. There it is, and I have a recipe going up on it tomorrow. It is so delicious, I can't even explain to you. So I just made that and then some carrots and Brussels sprouts on the side. But if you're interested, ignore my cross out. But here is my chicken scratch with the recipe on there. If you are interested in making it, it's really, really good, and we're gonna get it on our belly. So I hope you got some ideas from this video, and thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next week or tomorrow. Bye.